We are ghosts. While most spirits pass on to the afterlife, we are the unfortunate few cursed to spend eternity. Oh, and she's gone.
Oh, good for her.
Bro, check out that body. Slamming.
Indeed. He'd have made a fine militiaman.
You light this stuff, and it wards off evil spirits.
What did she say?
Does that work?
It's gonna make an amazing hotel.
What is hotel?
I'll tell you what a hotel is. A hotel is our worst nightmare. Every room in this house filled with people coming and going. Sleeping in our beds. Libertines! And you don't even want to know about the clutter, Thorfinn, my fastidious Viking friend.
That husband fella would overpower. I mean, have you seen his shoulders and that V-shaped back?
Who died of dysentery?
Yeah, it smells like a fart when the living walk through you.
Okay.
I would actually love it. There was this amazing scene where the main girl was making pottery.
We don't have time for this.
And then this hunky shirtless guy comes in.
Well, we do have some time. The haunting isn't imminent. Go on.
Haunting is hard. Ooh, that is rank.
Shut up.
All right.
Yes, I agree, and I'm willing to try something different. Yes. Below 14th Street.
He's cute.
Funny.
Thankfully, you're looking at the man who negotiated an end to the siege of Fort Ticonderoga.
You surrendered unconditionally to the British.
But we lived to fight another day.
You died of dysentery 2 weeks later.
Did I? Thank you. Thank you. You're talking about Alexander Hamilton? Did that little twerp become famous?
Oh, wait, isn't that the guy on the $10 bill?
The what?
They seem really real.
Of course, what do you mean? He's on paper currency? This Jay fellow has ruined our ability to communicate with Samantha by convincing her that we are not real, which is a serious setback, in the face of which a lesser leader might give up. Like, for instance, oh, I don't know, Hamilton.
Dude is obsessed.
He was a terrible commander. He was all about himself, whereas I was known for making men under me happy. Yes, we will pester her in the kitchen.
Yeah.
We will annoy her in the living room.
Idea.
We will make her life a living hell, so she has no choice but to finally acknowledge us.
Yes!
Yes!
Okay, I need you to look up Alexander Hamilton on this.
Do you know how long it would take me to type all those letters?
I must know what he went on to do. He haunts me, and I'm a damn ghost.
Come on! Come on! Mm-mm. Oh, amazing. Okay, next letter, next letter!
And then we looked up Isaac.
Graduated Dartmouth, died of dysentery. That's it? That's all it says? I was mentioned in but one academic journal, in a footnote. I'm literally a footnote in history, whereas my rival is known to this day. There was even a musical about him.
You really fixated on that musical thing.
Well, this might come as a shock to you since you see me as this tough military type. Mm. But musical theater is actually a passion of mine. I heard you mention you were a writer. I'd like you to pen my biography so that history may know my name.
Now that is actually quite interesting.
And then take that book and adapt it into an award-winning Broadway musical. Mm-mm. More righty-righty, less talky-talky. Now, where was I?
You were telling me about your wife.
She was a handsome woman. We slept in separate bedrooms to keep the flame of our passion burning bright. Now, let's talk military service. I was a beloved commander, though I was known for riding my men hard.
Okay, so I guess we just vote?
Fine.
Yeah.
Okay, uh-huh, let's
great.
Do it.
Oh, if only it were that simple. No, my friends, democracy, though the best form of government, is a tedious and flawed process. There will be hours of debate. Long, boring speeches we'll have to sit through. Or we could dispense with all of that, pick me, and be done with it.
That's great. Mazel tov, you win. Done.
Wonderful. You've chosen wisely, my friends. Now it is tradition for the victor to give some remarks. Don't worry, I'll keep it to a brisk hour. I knew from an early age.
Screw it. I'm running against this windbag.
What? Ooh.
Not because I want the gig. I just don't want him to have it.
This is ridiculous. You were a singer.
I was at the signing of the Declaration of Independence.
No, you weren't.
I was outside. They started early. Point is, I practically invented democracy.
Actually, indigenous governments were the model for American federalism, so.
But the Electoral College and the powdered wig. Oh my, come on. I fully endorse your position, which is why you should vote for me. Illegitimate though that vote may be.
Wow, no one ever thinks of us.
Oh, but I do. I think of you. In fact, I will have vivid memories of this conversation for a long, long time.
I'm a man of the people. Good day. Oh my God. But true democracy leaves no one behind, and they stand with me, but not too close, not too close.
Yeah, democracy is broken. It's a flawed system, everyone.
I was never the type the commoners like to have an ale with. Those dirty, filthy, ignorant commoners.
Hard to see why they didn't like you.
Agreed. It's a mystery.
But I gotta say, watching my man fire that arrow, pretty hot.
Indeed. The fire is what's hot. As fire is, and no one can argue with that. So.
Oh, I live for dinner parties. The repartee, the gentle mocking of the hostess when she leaves the room. You call those potatoes, Abigail?
Ooh, what vintage is that? Let me see.
No!
Woodstone mention tradition.
He's so funny. And you are so clumsy.
Who is writing your memoir?
Well, actually, on that, I do have a few notes.
Samantha, I must protest. We have just as much of a right to attend this dinner party as you.
No, because this is our house.
We've been here longer than you.
Yeah, there's going to be a lot of Carol Baskins hooking up with baby Yodas this year.
I know it's English, and yet I gleaned nothing. We don't have time for frivolous entertainment. We must set up sentries. An attack is nigh.
Okay, take it easy. We should do shifts or something. Some of you stand around, keep a lookout, while I watch a talk with Trev.
Oh, you know what? I'll join you.
What? No, you guys are the worst army ever.
Fine, fine. But the rest of us will keep watch and alert the livings so they may confront our vandals.
We were actually planning on egging the place, but after seeing you guys and seeing how cool you are, it just doesn't feel right anymore.
This feels like a trap. I hate to say I told you so. Wait, no, it's actually quite satisfying. You know what I would do if I were alive and the telephone had been invented? Call their mommies.
Troops, we all saw the threatening gesture made by young Zach. It doesn't take a military genius, which I am, to know that we must be on guard for a new attack. Oh, this isn't good. They worked forever on this. I watched Jay Sand for hours, getting sweatier and sweatier.
Well, the good news is that there's nothing they can really do. We're ghosts. We're impervious to their worldly punishments.
They could take away our TV.
Wait, no, but there's a new season of The Bake Off.
Oh, the kids did it.
I got this.
And that's what happened, and that's what we all saw. All's well that ends well. Oh, God, I believe it's Sunday. Pete, I think it's time for food club.
Oh, where did we leave off last week?
Thor was talking about cards.
Oh, yes, you're right. Absolutely. Yes. It was quite a cliffhanger, if I recall.
Not so fast. Something doesn't smell right here.
Well, I think everything smells perfectly fine.
Spill it, iceberg. What are you sitting on?
Okay, kids didn't do it. I did.
What? Good God, man, that's all it took?
Well, we can't just frame them. This goes against everything I stand for.
Oh, really, Pete? Because from where I'm sitting, I see a man who for the past 40 years has blathered on about his troop and things like loyalty. I mean, you literally have a loyalty badge.
So?
So, we are your troop now. Your loyalty lies with us. So what's it gonna be, Pete? The ghosts or the livings, hmm?
I stand with Pete.
Wait, what? But Pete's on the side of good. I mean, the other side.
It's 100% those kids.
It was the kids.
And frankly, we're a little offended that you would even accuse us of something so heinous.
A quick word, if I may, Samantha. It wasn't the kids. We lied. We burned down the gazebo, so. Okay, carry on. I'd like to take this opportunity to formally apologize for this evening's, you know what, let's call them missteps, shall we? Because I think we all learned a very valuable lesson.
Shut it, Isaac.
Ooh, yep.
No TV, 1 week.
But The Bake Off!
I get it from the ghost perspective, because they ain't got nothing going on. No offense, guys.
No, that's fine. If it means anything, I would completely understand if Beatrice ended up with my best mate, Edward. I mean, who could blame her? them, for finding comfort in each other's arms.
Well, here they come. Oh, yeah, find a spot for it. My so-called best friend and my so-called wife.
Mm. Well, I mean, she was literally his wife, any act of indiscretion notwithstanding.
Oh, is that so, Isaac?
I mean, grammatically, yes, but not hugely important right now.